Hi, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. Today, I want to show you how to use Copilot on your iPhone. I want to give you 5 tips so you can get started right away. The first step is getting Copilot installed on your iPhone. Just go over to the App Store. You're going to see that this is a free download. Once you do that, let's go ahead and get started. You can start using Copilot right away on your iPhone. You don't even have to sign in. Now, I would suggest that you do sign in the top left-hand corner. And if you don't have an account, just go ahead and create a free one. I'm just showing you with my free one today. Now, once you do sign in, you get a couple more options. You can have longer conversations and ask more questions. And I like having those extra perks with using my free account. Using Copilot on your iPhone is like having your own personal assistant. You can ask it anything. Now, before I ask it anything, I just want to show you a few settings that you can adjust before it gives you the answer. Now go up to the top right-hand corner and click on those 3 little ellipses. So notice that we have show all tones. By default, we're on balance. So you can see how the blue is chosen in the middle. But if I go ahead and select creative, and it gives kind of a definition of what creative is, you know, original imaginative chat versus precise over here where it's straightforward chat. And depending on what you pick out of these, it will maybe take a little bit longer when it's creating its response to you. But before you go ask a question, think about what you might want. I'm just going to leave it on more balance, but I want to make sure that you adjust those as you need. Now I can go back up. I can hide those tones back again. The other thing is you can turn on ChatGPT-4 just by sliding it over. So you can see responses may be slower while creative, but you can go ahead and use that as well. Let's go ahead and ask it a question for us. Now let's go ahead and ask it anything. So just click on in the bottom where you can start typing, and I'm just going to go and ask it what are the best beaches to go to. And let's see what type of information it gives me back. Now you can see the response that they gave me, and they brought this information from a few different sites, which are down at the bottom where I can click on those and see where they pulled this from. Now, when you're asking it to do something, you can go ahead and ask it by just with your voice. So click on the little microphone and ask it a question. What should I pack on my next beach vacation?
A beach vacation is a great way to relax and enjoy the sun, sand, and sea. But before you go, you need to pack the right items to make your trip comfortable.
As you heard, it even reads it to you. Now, I want to move over to the camera button because this can do some amazing searching for you. When I go ahead and choose the camera button, then line up what I want it to chat about. You notice at the very bottom, I can go between chat, search, QR, and barcode. And on the left-hand side, I can choose images from my library as well. But let's just go to chat. And once I got that lined up in my camera, I'm just going to click on the chat. And you're going to see that it comes up with Ask Me Anything. And I'm just going to say, what is this? And send that away. It came up with the correct response of what was sitting on my desk, and it even gave me some ideas of how I could dig into this further. Now, this could come in handy if you're outside looking at types of flowers or animals, and you can do this same thing. I hope you like those first 3 tips on how to use Copilot on your iPhone. This next tip is my favorite, and it's about creating images on Copilot. So Copilot connects to DALL 3, which is a generative AI that creates images from whatever you describe. Now, you do have to ask it to create an image or draw a picture, and the more detail you give, the more exact it will be. It's not always a perfect thing, but it's a lot of fun to try to see what it can create. Let's go through and get an example done. I'm just going to click on it and I'm going to ask it to draw an image of a pig riding a unicorn. So I'm going to do it by voice. Draw me a picture of a pig riding a unicorn. And I'm just going to go ahead and send that now. And it's going to go through and attempt to create this. Now, there's the examples that it gave me. And again, the more description, if I wanted it to look more photoreal, I could have said that. Now, I can go ahead and click on these. And at this point, since I clicked on that one in the right-hand corner, top right-hand corner, I can go and share it at this point or download it from here. So have some fun creating some images on Copilot on your iPhone. My last tip on how to use Copilot on your iPhone is probably the most obvious, but how you can use it to create content in seconds. Just like many of the other AI tools that we have out there, whether it be ChatGPT, go ahead and ask it to do something. So I'm going to go down below and just say, create an email, and I'm just going to paste this one in. It's going to write me an email to my boss asking for a raise. If I go ahead and send this, it's going to go through and write me this that I can copy paste into an email. Now, there's many other things that you can create with this, whether you want to summarize something, build a resume, play games, give advice, write code. You have lots of different options. And notice when you do this, the copy is right there. So you can go ahead and click on the copy and paste it into an email all right onto your phone. So what do you think about Copilot on your iPhone? Is it something that you would use, or is there another option out there that you find that works better for you? I'd really like to know what that is, because I like to learn about new tech all the time. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.